Hello all, I am Dr. Soundarya. Welcome back to iLovePhD for a useful video. As a young researcher, you might wonder how to start writing your first review paper and the extent of the information that it should contain. In this video, you will learn how to write a good review paper. A step-by-step systematic procedure is explained with a sample review paper format to get more citation. First, let us understand the definition of review paper. It is a comprehensive summary of the current understanding of the specific research topic, and it is based on previously published research works. Unlike research papers, it does not contain new results but can propose new inferences based on the combined findings of the previous research works. The main objective of writing a review paper is to evaluate the existing data or results, which can be done through analysis, modeling, classification, comparison, and summary. Review papers can help to identify the research gaps, to explore potential areas in a particular field. It also helps to come out with new conclusions from the already published works. Any scholar or researcher or even scientist who wants to carry out research on a specific theme first have to read the review papers relevant to your area of research to understand the research gap for arriving at the problem statement. Writing a review article provides clarity, novelty, and contribution to the area of your research, and it demands a high level of in-depth understanding of the subject and a well-structured arrangement of discussions and arguments. Some journals publish only review papers and they don't accept research papers. It is important to check the journal submission guidelines. Review articles are typically of three types. They are literature reviews, systematic reviews, and meta-analysis. A literature review is a general survey of research topic, and it aims to provide a reliable and unbiased account of this current understanding of the topic. A systematic review is more specific and attempts to address a highly focused research question. Its presentation is more detailed, with information on the search strategy used, the eligibility criteria for inclusion of certain studies, the methods utilized to review the collected information. A meta-analysis compares and evaluates a defined number of similar studies. It is quantitative in nature and it helps to assess contrasting study findings. Now let us understand the key differences between a review paper and a research paper. Review paper actually summarizes and evaluates the existing research on a particular topic. It is focused on comprehensive overview of the current state of knowledge on a specific topic. Review papers have a more flexible structure, allowing authors to organize the content based on thematic or chronological approaches. However, they generally include an introduction, main body discussing various aspects of the topic, and a conclusion. Review papers do not involve original data collection. Instead, they extensively analyze and summarize existing studies using systematic literature review methods. Review papers incorporates a wide range of primary and secondary sources to present a comprehensive overview of a topic, whereas research paper presents new findings or discoveries in a specific field of study. It is focused on original research and experimentation. It follows a structured format, that is introduction, methods, results, discussion, and conclusion. We have already discussed about how to write a good research paper. If you are new, I'm giving the link in the description box. You can check it. And research papers involve the collection of data, experimentation, or analysis of existing data to answer specific research questions. Research papers rely on primary sources to support and justify their findings, emphasizing recent and relevant research. So both type of papers are important contributions to the academic community, but they serve different purposes and have different characteristics. So that differences we need to understand before writing a review paper or a research paper. Then, criteria for a good review paper. According to Perlmutter, a good review paper should have three criteria. The first one, area of research should be suitable for writing a review paper so that the author finds sufficient published literatures. Second, a review paper should be written with suitable literatures, detailed discussion and sufficient data or results to support their interpretations. Third, a completed review paper should provide substantial new innovative ideas to the readers based on the comparison of published works. Here comes the most exciting part of this video, that is systematic procedure to write a review paper. The first step is defining your research question. Take your time to identify the research question and carefully articulate the topic of your review paper. A good review should add new ideas and knowledge to the field in terms of a hypothesis, inference, or conclusion. A carefully defined scientific question will give you more clarity in determining the novelty of your inferences. Then, identify relevant sources. Collect research and review papers relevant to your research with the help of multiple databases or search engines that are available. Do an extensive literature review, identify research gaps, and then frame a suitable problem statement. Third step is to take notes. A literature review generally involves extensive reading, which is difficult to recollect it. So make notes while conducting the literature search and note down the source references. This will ensure that you have sufficient information to start writing. Then, based on the literature survey, propose a suitable title, write abstract and introduction. A good starting point to begin structuring your review is by drafting the title, abstract and introduction. Write down what your review aims to address in the field will help to shape the rest of your article. B is done. Evaluate every piece of evidence in a critical but unbiased manner. This will help you to present a proper assessment and a critical discussion in your article. Finally, end by stating strong take-home message and identify the limitations of the existing studies that need to be addressed through future studies. Then ask your mentor and fellow scholars to provide feedback on both the content and the language of your article before you submitting it. Check for journals' guidelines carefully. Some journals only publish review papers while some only publish research articles. Generally, all journals clearly indicate their aim and scope. So, make sure to check the appropriateness of a journal before submitting your article. Now, let us look into the sample review paper format. It should include the following 10 components. First one, choose a suitable title, then a well-written abstract containing not more than 250 words, keywords relevant to your review paper, that is 6 to 8 keywords are essential. This will maximize the visibility of your paper for the readers to find your work. Then comes introduction. Present a detailed introduction to your research, which is published in chronological order in your own words. Don't summarize the published literatures. Instead, it should encourage the readers to read your paper. Then discuss the critical issues under various subsections. Make sure you present a critical discussion, not a descriptive summary of the topic. If there is contradictory in your research, make sure to include an element of debate and present both sides of the argument. A good review paper can resolve the conflict between the contradictory works. You can also use tables and figures to present your data. Finally, conclusion. The written review paper should achieve your objectives. Hence, the review paper should leave the reader with a clear understanding of the following questions. That is, what they can understand from the review paper and what still remains a requirement of further investigation in the research area. This can include making suggestions for future scope of the study and also include the limitations in the existing study. Then acknowledgement. The authors can submit a brief acknowledgement of any financial instrumentation and academic support received during the research work. Citing the references at the appropriate places in the article is necessary and important to avoid plagiarism. Each journal has its own referencing style. So, references need to be listed at the end of the manuscript. The number of references in the review paper is usually higher than in the research paper. You can also submit the supporting information as annexes, which you think it is necessary. Now we have come to end of this video. Writing review paper or systematic reviews or meta-analysis can seem like a challenging task. However, it offers a multitude of benefits to the scientific community. It not only provides comprehensive overview of the literatures, but also allows the researchers to contribute to their field, to get more citation for their work and suggesting future directions. So this video serves as a valuable resource for the researchers by providing useful tips on how to write an effective review paper that stands out and gets published. Thank you.